think paradise in Islam is only meant for the male. It is not meant for the female. This misconception can be removed by quoting from Surah Nisa, chapter number 4, verse number 124, which says, وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِنَ الصَّالِحَاتِ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أَوْ أُنْسَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَأُولَٰئِكَ يَدْخُلُونَ الْجَنَّةَ وَلَا يَظْلُمُونَ نَقِيرًا. Which means, if any of you do deeds of righteousness, whether it be male or a female, and have faith, they shall surely enter paradise.
Hello everyone, peace of Christ to all. We heard this Zakir Naik, he is saying that the Western, they say that the heaven of Islam is made for the male, and he was quoting verses for us to prove that there is a lot of females in the heaven. Actually, this was not the question, and this is showing us his disability to answer. The question is, this heaven is made for the man. Who said that women, they will not be there? You know, when we say the restaurant, this restaurant is made for men, does not mean there is no women there. There's the dancer, there is the stripper maybe, right? Those filthy places. And there is the waitress. But the stripper and the dancer and the one who do belly dancing for the Muslims and the waitress, they are not there to enjoy. They are there to serve. They are there to be used. So showing me that a Muslim woman, she will be in the heaven, you prove nothing. The question is, what are her, you know, what is her position in the heaven? What she will be doing in the heaven? What is her joy in the heaven? Muhammad, he said, the Muslim woman, she will be 70 times more beauty of the Hur al-Ain. So she will be 70 times more beauty. This is the only reward for Muslim women if she go to heaven. This is mean, even that beauty is not made for her, because simply how she can enjoy it? She will be in the bedroom jailed with her husband. So even her beauty is a reward for the man, not for her. What she will do with this beauty? She is jailed in a bedroom for sex. So we do not need an answer saying to us to quote verses saying, oh, they will be in the heaven. And the funny one, he quote a verse saying that the women, the man and the women, they will have justice in the heaven. You know, what justice mean? Justice is mean to have equal right, right? Do the Muslim women have equal right in the heaven? Where is the justice? The Muslim man, he will have 72 horny women, at least as the lowest reward, in the top of them all of his wives on earth. Do the Muslim women will have 72 horny men created for sex for her, in the top of them her husbands on earth? The answer, no. So where is the justice? How come he will have special gift from Allah of 72 created women at least? By the way, this is the lowest reward. Muhammad, he said the lowest reward is 72 horny women. Each one of them, her butt is 1 mile size, and the 300 boys servant, support the servant, not to have sex with, but only, this is what the Muslims says, I will go with them. So all the benefit is for the man. The woman, she will be a reward herself, she have no reward. You know, ask yourself, if a woman, she was married to her husband, and he died, she died, then judgment day did come, and she went to heaven, oops, she is with her husband again. What if she don't like him? Where's the reward? Is that a reward or a punishment? But now we will see, more important from this, what is the conditions Islam made for the women to go to heaven? This is Ask Imam website, askimam.org. This is a very Islamic website, and this is the fatwa number from South Africa, and this is the question. A man, he's asking, what is the right of husband over his wife and vice versa when it's come to sexual communion between the two? So the answer is coming as the following. We don't have much time to read everything, but I hope you can freeze the video and you can read everything you see in the screen. In here he's saying, the marriage is a contract between the two partners. And then let us go to the most important things. This is clearly evident by the following quotation of the Nabi, which means Muhammad, which he mentioned, if a woman, and here the word is should be a man, if a woman call her, call his wife, which this is why I'm saying this is a mistake, if a man call his wife to his bed and she does not come to him, the angels will curse her until the morning. Guys, so the Muslim woman, she will go to heaven. But if she are doing her duty, which Allah, he made her for, what is her duty? To take off her panties anytime, anywhere. Actually, the Quran says, your women the same as a turf for you. You dig in the turf any and how you want. Which means she is the same as the field. And you dig in the ground anytime you want and anywhere you want. So if the woman, she say no, Allah himself, the angels, they will curse her. And you know what curse mean? Curse mean no heaven, simply. Somebody is cursed, there is no heaven for him. He continue, giving proofs one after one. By him, in whose his hand whose hand is my soul. He's saying, Muhammad is swearing, he's swearing by Allah, the one who owned the soul of Muhammad, or he owned the, he's holding the soul of Muhammad by his hand, which is Allah. There is no man who calls his wife to the bed and she refuses him, but the one who is in heaven will be angry with her until the husband is pleased with her once more. Reference, Sahih Muslim. So, who is the one in the heaven will be angry with her? It is Allah. So, if the woman, she did not open her legs to her husband for any reason, Allah himself will be angry in the heaven. You see, Allah is watching every Muslim woman's legs. If they are open or closed, you don't open it, Allah get upset. And he is making this a condition to go to heaven. As you see, he's angry. Someone, Allah angry from him, he will never go to heaven. So what is the key for a Muslim woman to go to heaven? Simply to open her legs. Number three, Allah will curse those women who, when their husbands call them to their beds, they say, I will, until he fell asleep. You see, Allah? Allah, man, this God, no, no, you can't play games with him. Don't, you cannot play tricks. Hello, Allah is watching your legs. You say, I will, you have to open them right away. Look, Allah is cursing you for saying, I will. You have to come right away. And they are telling us, the Muslim women, she have rights, and she will go to heaven. Where is the heaven? As we see, the heaven of Islam is havoc. It's only by opening the legs. Can the Muslim woman ask her husband? And if he say, no, I cannot, I will, do Allah curse the man? Never. How come he will curse the women? But still, they say to you, Islam give equal rights now, right? You continue. Number four, if a man calls his wife, then she should come, even if she is busy at the oven. Man, it doesn't leave the fire and leave everything. Come to the sex. He want it now, you do it now. Shut up. The sexual is the most important part in marriage in Islam. Taking care of the kids, the woman, she is sick, it doesn't matter. Open your legs. And the list continue. Number five, three people who praise will not be accepted, nor their good deeds. First, disobedient slave. Oh, the slave have to be obedient, man. You see, Islam is against slavery. Until he returned to his master. Or a woman who her husband is angry with her. Until he is pleased with her again. Number three, a drunk card until he became a sober. So, the an obedient woman, she will never have a prayer accepted. So even a prayer is not accepted, which means not only you will not go to heaven, you have no mercy of God. Allah will burn you for not satisfying every need of a husband. And you know what? This is goes, even if you are, let us say, a woman, she was always ready for her husband for 50 years. One day, she is not good. She said no. Allah is cursing her. He forgot everything she did, and he, right away he started cursing her. She will go to hell. So what we see, and he is saying in here, you can read by yourself, take your time, that from above, clearly evident that the right of the husband of the wife, over the wife, whenever the urge he may ask to have relation, she have to do it. She have to do it right away. Otherwise, Allah himself will be cursing her and she will be out of heaven. She will never enter heaven. So when they say to us, women, she have equal right and she have a place in heaven, who is that woman? Simply is a sex slave. She was sex slave on earth. She will get to heaven to be a sex slave in heaven again. You know what? I advise you Muslim women not to go to heaven, because there you will serve eternity of slavery for sex. If this is your position in earth, what is your position in heaven? Why the Prophet of Islam, he say, the man who his wife asks him to come to bed, if he say no, he will not enter heaven. It's very clear what Islam speaks for. Christ is Lord, Islam is false. Amen.